Good morning, children. Today, some few things which it is not in your book, we are going to learn. In this new books, this year we are having a new books. Last year it was a different book, and there are many things it is not there. Only some basic things are there. Some few things are not there that you should learn. That I am going to teach you. So the first thing is that multiplication fact. Multiplication fact. Otherwise, we can say multiplication properties. Properties of multiplication. So you learnt in here property of 0 and property of 1. You learnt, but some you didn't learn. That is, in first addition and subtraction, you learnt associative property and commutative property. So same these properties are there for multiplication also. So now I am going to teach for multiplication commutative. Commutative property. So this is same thing as like in addition. Okay, commutative property, I told you to remember two numbers in commutative property, two numbers. Commutative means communicative, that way you remember. To communication you need two person, to communicate you need two person. So in commutative property there will be two numbers. Now if you see, let me take an example. Now 4 into 3, 4 threes are 12, 4 threes are 12. Now if you change the order of this number, okay, here 4 was first, 3 was second. Now we have changed the order, 3 first and 4 second we have written. 3 fours are 12. So when you change the order of the number, the product doesn't change. The product is the same. You are getting the same product. Okay, this is called commutative property. This is same thing there in addition also. You can see that it would be given in order. Now number order of the number. Same thing. This is commutative property. When you change the order of the number, the product doesn't change. That is called the commutative property. Now next one is the associative property. Okay, before seeing that associative property, let me give you how the questions can be asked. In this, filling the blanks can be asked like this. Suppose if it is given like this, 12 into 5 equal to dash into 12. This is the way it can be asked. So when you change the order, the answer product doesn't change. So this is 12 into 5 means, so this side it should be 5 into 12. So you have to see equal sign. Equal sign must be middle. So this is on the left side, this is on the right side. So left side and right side, you see whether the numbers are same numbers are there. The numbers can be any in any order, but all the numbers should be there. 12 is there, so here 12 is there, 5 is there, so 5 is missing here, so we are writing. So this is the way it can be asked in filling the blanks using the commutative property. And also it can be asked like this. Now 12 into 5 equal to 5 into 12 equal to 60. So what is the property used here? The name of the property used here. So here the name of the property used here is commutative property. So you must know the name of the property. Okay, next one is the associative property. Association. Association means group. So group means more than two. So it is more than many people will be there. So associative means group of numbers. When the numbers are grouped into different groups, when the numbers are grouped into different groups, and when you find the product doesn't change. That is called associative property. I will give a small example now. I am taking a 3 number, 2 into 3 into 5. So this 3 number I am taking. So I am first grouping this first two numbers. First two numbers I am grouping into one group, and the third number another group. Third alone one group, and these two are one group. So now I am multiplying 2 threes are 6. So in this group the product is 5, and that product I am multiplying with this the another group, that is the remaining number. So 6 fives are 30. So here when you group the first two number, you are getting the product is 30. Okay, now I am making it now the second and third number as another group. Okay, second and third number I am making another group, and I am just leaving the first number single. Okay, so whatever is grouped, that only first you have to multiply. So I am writing 2 as it is, and what is inside the bracket, only first you have to multiply. 3 fives are 15. 3 fives are 15, and now this multiplied, you have to, what you have got that product, you have to multiply with the number, the single number. So now 2 fifteens are 30. Okay, now you look here. Here the group is different, here the group is different, but the product is the same. So this is called associative property. If you may make the group, if you make the numbers into different groups, but the product doesn't change, that is called the associative property. So here also it can be the same way as for commutative. The questions can be asked like filling the blanks. Now I will give an example. 7 into dash multiply 3 equal to dash into dash into 6 into 3. So now both side also can be asked dash, otherwise only one dash also can be asked. So now here what you will do, first here 7 is here, but here 7 is missing, 7 is not there, so that missing number you can write in the dash. And now if you see here, 7 already, 3 is here, so this 6 is not here, so that 6 will come in the dash. So which number is missing, that number you fill in the blanks. Again the properties also, the name of the property can be asked. After giving like this, the name of the property used here, they can ask. Okay, so this is the way the questions can be asked. So it will be only like fill in the blanks, but this is important for higher classes you need. So you must know what is commutative property and associative property. Still there are some properties are there that you will learn in class 4. For class 3, these two are important and you must know, but it is not in your book, so you have to learn. I am giving you. Okay, next one is the division facts. Okay, you may think that in multiplication we are learning why division is coming, because each multiplication has two division facts. Each multiplication has two division facts. Don't forget, each multiplication has two division facts and each division has two multiplication facts. So let me give an example now. Now let's take 5 into 6. 5, 6 are 30. Okay, this is in multiplication. Now we have to use only these three numbers, 5, 6, 30. Only we have to use these numbers, and you have to write a division here. So how we can write? For division, you need the biggest number first. So in this 5 and 6, 30, which is the bigger number? 30 is the bigger number. So we write 30. Then 30 divide by any one of this number. 30 divide. So let's write 5. So how many 5s are 30? 6 5s are 30. So only these three numbers are coming. You see 5, 6, 30. Here also 5, 6, 30. So each multiplication has, there is a division fact also is there. So now another way also you can write 30 divide. This number you exchange, change the place. That's all. This is a division fact. You have learned in addition fact and subtraction fact, you have learned the same way. This is for multiplication division fact. To write the division fact, first you write in this three number, the biggest number, which is the biggest number that you write first. Then it is the division fact, so you put the division sign. Again, reminding that two small numbers are there, no? In that, first you can write any one of the number. After equal sign, you write the other number which you have not written. Okay, now second fact, you have to write the same biggest number first, then just you exchange the number what you have written already, just change the order of the number, that's all. If you are not getting how to find out when you divide what you will get, Okay, you may make mistake also. Dividing, you will not know how many fives are 30, how many six are 30, you may not know. So for them, I'm giving you these tricks. First, you write the biggest number. So again, remaining the smaller number, just you write one before the equal sign, one after equal sign. Then in the next one, you write the same bigger number first. Then you change the order of the number. This is the way you write the division facts. Okay, now next one. Okay, next we are going.